Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Loud. I'm your host, Weaver Beats. Today I'll be explaining to you guys compression. What is it? What do we do with it? And some other basic concepts. Let's go! Compression is often used to make music sound louder without actually increasing its peak amplitude. Compression is the process of lessening the dynamic range between the loudest and softest parts of an audio signal. This is done by boosting the quiet signals and lowering the high ones. The controls you're given to set up a compressor are your threshold, ratio, attack, release, and your makeup gain. The threshold is used to set what loudness will trigger the compression. The ratio is how much compression will be done. It's done on a ratio basis. And this can be anywhere from 1 to infinity. The attack and release lets you change how long the compression takes to set in and how long it takes for it to come off. And the makeup gain is used to makeup gain. Make up the gain that you lost. There are also some compressors that have auto makeup gain, which is also a nice feature. Quite often they are not completely accurate though. Compression is used to make music sound louder without actually increasing the peak amplitude. Now, if we sit here and really think about that sentence, it tells you almost everything you need to know about compression. It compresses the peaks and gives you more room. So if you imagine those peaks going down, then you should be able to imagine yourself having more room there. It can also be used to automatically tame amplitude, but it's much better to do this manually. It can be used as a sidechain to create room for other instruments. Compression can also be used in parallel to make things sound louder and more aggressive. Parallel means sending something on a return. So having your compression on a return and then sending signal to it. You can beef up the sound of your drums without actually losing any peaks. That's the true beauty of parallel compression. You can use parallel compression on other things as well. There are also some other tools that are very related to compressors that I'll try to briefly explain. These tools include limiters, maximizers, and multiband compression. The difference between a compressor and a limiter is only in the compression ratio that is used. A compressor lets you control how much compression ratio you can use, but a limiter is stuck at 10. A limiter is intended to limit the maximum level. A compressor is used for less drastic and more creative control type situations. A limiter is meant to completely stop sound, and a compressor is meant to shape it more so. A maximizer is technically very similar to a limiter. It stops audio from passing a certain threshold, but it also makes up for the difference, thusly being named a maximizer, because it maximizes the loudness. Many maximizers also have their own proprietary technology to take care of specific frequencies and to keep your mix sounding the same all the way through to the final stages. Multiband compressor splits up the audio into different bands. You can set the frequencies of the bands, and each band has its own compressor, and you can use them to individually control the compressors on each band, allowing you to get a variety of results that are quite different from a regular compressor. Beware of multiband compression. There is no easier way to destroy your sound than to put it through a multiband compressor and not know how to set it properly. You need to listen very carefully and you need to just not suck. Just don't suck. Okay, that's it for this video. Hopefully this clears up some things about compressors for you guys. A lot of people have been asking me about it. Figured I'd explain to you guys compressors, their brothers and sisters, and what they're all for. I'm your host, Weaver Beats. Check out my Patreon for exclusive videos, as well as exclusive content and early release content. Check out my second channel if you guys haven't. I upload gaming videos there, and I also live stream sometimes there. I'm planning to live stream more on this channel. I'm gonna do it every Friday if I can, so stay tuned. I may not post videos on some Fridays, but I will definitely live stream. A lot of you guys are like, Weaver, we don't wanna see you play games. We wanna see you produce. And I'm like, you're right. So I'm gonna do that. Anyway, make sure to tune in next time when I...